gracious ladies and gentlemen, I almost do not need to say anything, for you have already heard the core of my message. I am free because I am not defined by anything on earth. You will be free when you do not let anything on earth define you. What is it that the fallen beings want? They want to be like gods on earth. And how do you become a god on earth? By tricking the people on earth to worship you as the supreme authority, because you can control how they define themselves. What has the Catholic Church been doing since its inception? It has been attempting to cause those who thought they were followers of Jesus Christ to define themselves as the opposite kind of being as what Jesus demonstrated. Look at the concept of original sin, that you are sinners by nature, that God created you as a sinner. Could this idea ever have come from the mind of God? Nay, of course not. For why would God create you as a sinner when you have to make a certain choice in order to overcome that condition? Do you not see that the fallen beings are not necessarily denying free will because they are saying you are a sinner and in order to be saved you have to choose to follow them? But if God had created you with a capacity to overcome sin through choice, why would he create you as a sinner? Why would he not create you as a free being, so that sin is a result of choice and therefore can be overcome not by making the outer choice to follow the fallen beings, but by making the choice to look at yourself and overcoming the consciousness that keeps you trapped in a lesser image of yourself? What is sin, if there is such a thing as sin? Is it not that you are imposing an image upon yourself that is not in alignment with what God created? You are making yourself a god, for instead of accepting the reality that God created you as an extension of its own being, of the one mind, you are imposing an image upon yourself that you are a limited, flawed being. Do you not thereby think you know better than God what God created? Are you not thereby making yourself as a god, knowing good and evil, as the serpent said to Eve? And as the serpents indeed have said to every soul, every life stream in embodiment on earth. They have managed to make you believe in this lesser image of yourself that causes you to think that you are defined by conditions on earth, that you are defined by your own past choices, or that you are defined by conditions over which you have no power. This is the essence of the illusion that you are meant to overcome on earth in order to be free to move on. I know, my beloved, we have said this before, but we will continue to say it, because every time we say it, we go a step higher on the spiral staircase, And every time we say the same thing again, more people will be awakened by it being said in the physical. You may think that you have heard it before and you understood it the first time. But did you fully grasp it? For I tell you that when you look at the Buddha and how he taught, you will see that he repeated many things. And there is a reason for this. It is that there are levels of your consciousness. You are not instantly freed from duality, for it has taken you a long time to create the outer self. There is a dream perpetrated by the fallen beings, but reinforced and sustained by many spiritual and religious people, even many ascended master students, that of instant deliverance, instant salvation, instant transformation. There are some who believe that in order to be enlightened, you have to just switch your mind in some magical way, and then you are instantly free. It cannot be done, my beloved. If it could be done, we of the Ascended Masters would have taught it thousands of years ago, and all human beings would be free long ago. You are not a static, linear being. You are a spherical being. You have an extension in both space and time. Your consciousness is not confined to this physical body only. We have told you you have four lower bodies. But what we have not really told you is that the four lower bodies are not confined to time. You may think of your personal energy field, your aura, as being in existence around your physical body. Many spiritual people think even that the body produces the aura. You know that it does not, but you may still think that it is very much centered around this physical body. And of course, you think that the physical body lives in this time, in this present moment, in this location. And this is true of the body. But it is not true of your mind, the totality of your mind. You know that you can project your mind to a different physical location than where you are right now. You even know that some people have trained themselves to leave the body behind and mentally project themselves to a remote location. You also know that some people can do this by going backwards or forwards in time. Your energy field, your aura, your total mind does not exist only in the present moment. It goes as far into the past as you have any wound, any attachment, any unresolved belief or psychology. And as Master Moore made you aware of this morning, you all received a trauma when you first came into embodiment on this planet. You have not resolved that trauma fully, or you would not be in embodiment still. And therefore, your mind, your energy field, reaches all the way back to the first time you came into embodiment on Earth. And you are constantly being stretched by the fact that your conscious mind is moving on in time, but your subconscious mind is stuck back there. And as you keep moving forward in time, you get stretched more and more. And this is what many people feel as an undifferentiated stress, a pressure, a weight, an urge to do something that compels you many times to attack the spiritual path in an unbalanced way, because you know that you have to catch up. There is something you have to do, but you don't know what it is. And so you think you have to work harder, you have to give more degrees, you have to run, you have to choose not to do this and to do all these spiritual things and not do the unspiritual things. And so you become so anxious, so eager. And my beloved, I'm not finding fault with you here. I love the eager student who is willing to make an effort. I applaud that. But it is, as the old saying goes, good speed, bad sense of direction. Many of my students have that speed. They have the willingness to try, to try, to do something. They have a sense of urgency. But they do not see what is the real goal. And the real goal is to start reaching back into the past and resolving what keeps you tied to that distant time from which the earth and your conscious mind and physical body are moving away at an accelerated rate, my beloved. The entire universe is expanding at an accelerating rate, as science has discovered to their astonishment. They have not made the logical conclusion, which is that this can only happen if there is energy coming from outside the material universe to drive this expansion. But that is another issue for another time. What you need to realize is that even though you are on a dense planet that is not keeping pace with the rest of the universe, the Earth is still being pulled up at an accelerated rate. And this increases the urgency, the stress that you might feel. Many spiritual people feel in these last few years overwhelmed, burdened, like there's something they cannot put their finger on that is stressing them out. I would rather see you being stressed in, so that instead of thinking that the cause of your stress is out there, you realize it is in here. It is because there is some unresolved belief and trauma from your past that you have not seen, that you have not seen for what it is, and therefore you have not started working on it consciously because you have not recognized it. It has been filtered out, as the messenger said. The birth trauma, the cosmic birth trauma that you received when you first came into embodiment on Earth is so painful, so overwhelming to you, that there are processes in your subconscious mind that filter it out before it reaches the conscious mind, because in the past you felt it would be too overwhelming for you to look at it, too painful. But for most of you, my beloved, it is no longer too painful. I am not saying that all spiritual people are ready to look at this, but most of you who have followed Ascended Master's teachings for a long time and who have already given a certain amount of decrees and invocations, you are ready to acknowledge this birth trauma and to start working on it consciously. I'm not saying you are ready to go into it right this second, but you are ready to apply our decrees and invocations to start healing it so that you can start chipping away at it, lessening the energetic pull, and thereby you will reduce that stress factor that you have felt over these last several years. There is also another trauma that I would like to make you aware of, and it is the trauma of the Piscean Age. Most of you have been in embodiment, not necessarily continuously, but many times during the Piscean Age. Some of you have been in embodiment almost continuously during these past 2,000 years because you wanted to give that service you could give only by being in embodiment. That there were certain initiations that humankind was meant to overcome in those 2,000 years. And there is a certain trauma from having witnessed how the planet has not passed these initiations, how humankind has not passed the initiations of the Piscean Age. There's also a certain trauma of being exposed to the atrocities that most of you have experienced in past lifetimes, be it wars or torture or other forms of suppression. So right now you're feeling both the pull of your original trauma of coming to the earth, but also the trauma of the Piscean Age, which you need to resolve before you can fully make it into the Aquarian Age and the Aquarian consciousness. You cannot truly follow me into Aquarius before you have resolved this trauma that you received during Pisces. And of course, one of the major initiations of Pisces was precisely this, to overcome this idolatry where you think you can create a physical idol defined based on the current conditions in matter, and then you can confine spirit to that idol. They have done it with Christ. They have done it with Jesus. But they have also attempted to do it with me. And I am pointing out to you that they are Ascended Master students who think they are the faithful followers of Saint Germain, keeping my flame. But they are imposing an idolatrous image upon me, and it is keeping them from moving with me into Aquarius, and this is causing stress in them. And they think the only way to overcome it is to give more decrees and more violent things. But this is not going to help. It is not going to be overcome until you look at yourself, recognize that you have an idolatrous image of Saint Germain, and let it go into the fire that I am. This is an essential shift in consciousness. You must realize that I am not your image. I am the fire that is beyond any image and can burn the image. But if you worship the image, then you think you have no reason to let that image go into the fire. And so you may think now, but what if there is some aspect of my image of Saint Germain that is real? If I put my entire image of Saint Germain into the fire, will it not all be burned? Will Saint Germain not be burned by his own fire? Will he not be hurt? Well, of course I will not be burned by my own fire. You can safely put the totality of your image of Saint Germain into the fire of the flame of freedom, because whatever aspects of your image are real will not be burned by the fire. It will not be consumed by the fire. So, dare to let it all go into the fire and allow only what is real to emerge from that fire. If you are attached and unwilling to let it all go into the fire, then you are holding on to what is unreal, and that blocks you from following me into Aquarius. It cannot be any other way. I cannot, I will not violate the law of free will. If you say, that you want to hold on to this wonderful image of Saint Germain that you have created, I will respectfully withdraw my presence so it does not impinge upon your consciousness. But then you also will be left behind, for I will not stand still because you are standing still. I am freedom. I am constantly moving. How can you overcome war in Europe? Only by moving beyond it, by transcending it, not by holding on to any image. Do you realize that I have talked about an idolatrous image of God, an idolatrous image of me, but you also have idolatrous images of everything that is going on earth, because the fallen beings want you to believe that things have been so bad that they cannot be overcome, or that they require that someone is punished. They think that because such atrocities have been committed on the European continent, someone needs to burn forever in hell in order to compensate for this. But you see, the infinite God of love has no need for anyone to burn in hell for any length of time. Why would one God want a part of its own being to burn forever in hell? God wants all parts of its being to flow with the river of life and grow towards that point of reunion with Source. God has never defined any law, any condition that holds back the self-transcendence of any being with free will. God has never defined such a condition. The fallen beings have attempted to define such conditions and make people believe them. Believe them not. It is high time that you throw these last shackles off of you that are holding you trapped in these idolatrous images. How do you truly love your enemies and forgive those who have hurt you? Not by changing anything on earth, not by changing what happened in the past, which you cannot change, but by realizing that when you were hurt in the past, there is a part of your being that is attached there, that is stuck there. And you need to mentally go back and free that part of your being so it can catch up with the rest of you. Then you are free from that event in the past. But how will you free that part of your being? Only by practicing total forgiveness of those who were the instruments of precipitating the hurt. Only when you have no desire to punish them or make them feel bad will you be free. I'm not asking you to forgive out of some far-flung altruistic motive. I am asking you to forgive for the very practical reason that it is the only way to free yourself. Now, as was spoken about before, one of the heaviest burdens on the European continent is indeed the non-forgiveness towards the German people because of the Second World War and the Holocaust. Therefore, I ask you who are here to participate with me in an exercise of spiritual alchemy. I desire you to center in your hearts. I know you're already there, but still, find that point of stillness in your heart. Then from that stillness, from that love, allow yourself to look at whatever images you have in your mind of the Second World War, of the war itself, of what the German people did, of the Holocaust, the concentration camps. Allow yourself to look at these images. Then realize that I am manifesting my presence with you. I hold in my right hand a stone that resembles an amethyst, but is far more concentrated and powerful. I wish you to visualize that the amethyst is radiating an intense ray of violet flame that is completely consuming the image you are holding of the Second World War and the Holocaust. Visualize how this violet flame is consuming the image. First, it is consuming it in your own consciousness. Then it is consuming it in the collective consciousness of your home country. And then it is consuming it in the collective consciousness of all of Europe. And then you say with me, I repeat, I say the sentence one time, then we repeat it together. And I ask you, to as much as possible, stay centered in the heart, in that place of love. Remember what Archei Charity said about looking at war from love, from the consciousness of love. So I will say a sentence, and we repeat it together. I personally forgive the German people for the Second World War. Together.
I personally forgive the German people for the Second World War.
On behalf of all people of Europe, I forgive the German people for the Second World War.
On behalf of all people of Europe, I forgive the German people for the Second World War.
I personally forgive the German people for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
I personally forgive the German people for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
On behalf of all people in Europe, I forgive the German people for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
On behalf of all people of Europe, I forgive the German people for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
I personally forgive all people of Europe for the Second World War.
I personally forgive all people of Europe for the Second World War.
On behalf of all of the people of Europe, I forgive all people of Europe for the Second World War.
On behalf of all people of Europe, I forgive all of the people of Europe for for the Second World War.
I personally forgive all people of Europe for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
I personally forgive all people of Europe for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
On behalf of all people of Europe, I forgive all people of Europe for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
On behalf of all people of Europe, I forgive all people of Europe for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
I personally forgive Adolf Hitler for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
I personally forgive Adolf Hitler for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
On behalf of all people of Europe, I forgive Adolf Hitler for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
On behalf of all people of Europe, I forgive Adolf Hitler for the Holocaust and the concentration camps.
My beloveds, you have performed a cosmic service that has never before been performed on this continent. I am not asking you to be prideful, but I am not asking you to be prideful in the sense that you do not recognize the value of what you have just done. Truly, allow yourself to recognize that hardly any of the millions of people who are embodying in Europe have been willing to say what you just said. Allow yourself to recognize how necessary it is that people dare to say this, to feel it in their hearts, and to truly thereby set yourself free from the consciousness of the war and the Holocaust. This is such a heavy weight hanging over this continent. It is, as they say in America, the 300-pound gorilla that is in the room, but nobody dares to acknowledge that it's in the room. Nobody dares to talk about it. Nobody knows how to talk about this directly and openly. And this is indeed something I desire you to hold in your vision, and I desire you to make calls for this, that the people